So all of a sudden AI is everywhere. People who weren't quite sure what it was are playing with it on their phones. Is that good or bad?
For sure.
Nothing puts a poop in a person's pants faster than talking about AI.
Class is back in session for the fall. And there's one question on every professor's mind. Are students using AI to do the work?
Hell yeah, no comment.
Let's find out.
That shot was done by using artificial intelligence.
And people are using various tools to make these things possible. And speaking of tools, we're going to be diving deep into one of the biggest tools and pioneers in this AI. You feel me? And that tool is called
ChatGPT.
ChatGPT.
I'm going around campus asking FAU students if they use AI to cheat or gain inspirations and ideas to get their work done. Let's see who's going to be truthful on camera or lie and just be on some bullshit. You feel me? But remember, your boys, to don't like, don't comment, and most importantly, don't subscribe to my channel. Let's get it.
Post-pandemic, educators have noticed severe declines in students' ability to think critically and problem solve at the most basic levels. But now, with AI able to do the thinking for them, educators are awash in worry. Not merely for their jobs, but for the development of their students.
And be honest, do you use AI to help you write your papers and cheat or whatnot?
No.
Stop the cap.
I don't.
Is this gonna be going on an official record?
You don't gotta answer.
Maybe.
Hell yeah.
Hell yeah.
I use it as a tool, mostly. I don't use it to cheat. I use it for ideas, not to write my ideas.
I'll use them sometimes just to help me, like, structure the whatever I'm writing more.
I don't even hesitate, dog.
What?
Why am I wasting my time writing the paper, bro? Professor see this video and I'm like, what the f***? How you gonna feel?
How am I gonna feel? He shouldn't be worried about nothing but me getting that homework in.
No comment.
No comment?
Yes.
Oh,
no comment as well.
The accessibility is out there.
Yeah. But I just don't really capitalize off of it.
Because you're scared?
Not really because I'm scared, bro. Just not really in my desire to really use it.
Oh, nah.
You sure?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Stop the cap.
Bro, I'm not capping, bro.
Not really for writing my papers, but definitely getting the information from my papers.
Like, a lot of people going to lose their jobs in the future, but that's why you got to pick a job that don't, like, that can't be replaced.
Ladies and gentlemen, we got them.
Speaking of jobs, scriptwriters were on a 5-month strike last year.
This time last year, more than 10,000 TV and film writers were on strike.
And one of the key components of that was because of AI.
I know, like, with story writing, that there are some AI generators that
taking a lot of your jobs.
Don't get me wrong, that wasn't the main reason why writers went on strike, but it did play a role in it. I'm telling you, bro, AI's burning these guys out of business.
According to World Economic Forum, 85 million jobs will be replaced by AI by 2025.
I think a lot of people's concerns is just, hey, what about everyone's jobs?
Change caused by AI is going to be pretty radical. So there, you know, a lot of jobs that currently exist won't exist in the future. But I think there will be new jobs.
I mean, you kind of already answered it. Do you think AI is going to replace certain jobs in the workforce?
Oh yeah, most definitely. Like anything, like authors, like artists and stuff like that. Most definitely, jobs going to take over. That's why, like, you know, you got to really pick your career wisely. Because, you know, in the future, a robot going to be able to do what you do.
I personally think so, and that scares me because I am a computer science major. Like, so, like, that might affect us getting jobs after we graduate. So, it's like, I am scared of the future with the AI because it's evolving, like, crazy right now.
Well, it depends on the type of industry. If you have industries in which people really don't need to be there, like, kind of automation type things, like, even fast food in a sense like that, like, from the guy from, like, at the drive-thru window coming through and stuff like that, you don't really need a person like that, but, of course, it supplies people with jobs and demands. I think things that are more along of, like I said, humanities and stuff like that, things in which you need, like, a human sense of touch, I feel like those jobs won't be taken away.
Yeah, definitely. I think people can be replaced by AI, but it would not replace the human perspective.
No, I'm not.
Wait, well, how come you're not worried about it?
Because whenever there's a new innovation, there's always new jobs to be made.
I mean, don't get me wrong. Despite the popularity of AI in the past year and a half, AI still creeps me the f*** out. AI is in our music, art designs, and the videos we watch. I'm telling you, AI is everywhere. But the real question is,
Can you pinpoint what's real and what's not real?
Yeah, scary, right?
How do you feel about the current state of AI, especially being used in school?
Yeah, I don't think it's a bad thing at all.
Honestly, like, I can see the benefits when it comes to, like, AI for real, for real. Like, when it comes to, like, computing or data analyzing and stuff like that, like, it can very, like, very much help, like, when it comes to computing, all types of stuff like that.
I feel like it is used a little too much. You can use AI just to get through college. I feel like it should be limited to the point where it can help you, but not to the point where people are abusing it.
I mean, I think it's evolving. I think more people are starting to use it, but could be for the better or the worse. You'll have to, I guess time will tell.
When it comes to like stuff like humanities or even just critical thought, like AI is kind of a scary thing because you kind of get into like this kind of snowballing effect where people may believe up on some facts or basis, but without any stipulations of like seeing the concurrent evidence or even seeing the history behind some things.
It could be a good and a bad thing. It could be good for students to get different perspectives and give different ideas, but people can rely on it too much.
AI doesn't exist in a vacuum. It is part of society, and it has impacts on people and the planet. And as these models are being deployed, are being woven into the very fabric of our societies, our cell phones, our social media feeds, even our justice systems and our economies have AI in them. And it's really important that AI stays accessible so that we know both how it works and when it doesn't work.
Huh. We're back. After a long day of going around campus and asking students about AI and just getting the perspective and like inside of what AI is and how cool it is, it was quite interesting, you feel me? But we gotta understand that AI is here to stay. It's not going anywhere, and it's up to us to use it as a tool to enhance ourselves or just, you know, use it for brain rot. But AI is here to stay, and you know, let's see how it goes in the near future, you feel me? But like I always say, y'all boys, it's a don't like, don't comment, and most importantly, don't subscribe to my channel. And we're out. Pow. Hey, shout out to Rocco, fam. Rocco, show yourself on camera, you feel me? You help me get up here, fam, but I don't know how to get down, fam. So you jump from here?
Yep.
Say swear to God, bruh. Holy sh**.
Oh,
all right, 3, 2. All right, swear to God, 3, 2, 1. Good shit, bro.
Good shit.
Love, fam.
Oh, man.
Yeah, boys. All right.